Agarro a madrugada como se fosse uma criança.
Lisbon, the capital of Portugal. For centuries, her ships have sailed around the globe and brought to the European shores the first news of many unknown cultures in Africa, Asia, and the Americas. In each returning ship, there came also songs that spoke of the dangers of the voyage and of the fascination for the new worlds explored, full of exotic tunes and rhythms, but songs that also told of loneliness, homesickness, and the fragility of mankind against the fury of the elements and the unpredictable nature of human fate. In the 1820s and 30s, a new song was thus born in Lisbon, which was to become the very mirror of the multicultural identity of the city and of her people. It was called Fado, the same word that meant fate in the Portuguese language.
Oh, rua do Capelão.
The main roots of the early 19th century Lisbon, Fado, were in a sound dance of the same name that had developed in the Portuguese colony of Brazil, mixing European song patterns and syncopated African rhythms, both nostalgic and sensual. But Fado was immediately taken over by the people of the poor neighborhoods along the Lisbon harbor, and combined with local song and dance traditions to become a central element in the Lisbon popular culture. Soon, the taverns where Fado was sung began to attract the curiosity of other social groups of the city, seduced by the magic of this song. Around 1840, a young prostitute of the popular neighborhood of Moraria, Maria Severa, who is known as a remarkable Fado singer, became the first icon of the Fado tradition, whose name was to be remembered and celebrated in Fado lyrics ever since then. Fado soon expanded not only to the circuit of taverns around the outskirts of Lisbon, but even to the drawing rooms of the middle classes and to the theaters. But by the turn of the century, Fado also became associated with the growing trade union and socialist movement as a song of political protest and of social reform, often with radical propaganda lyrics. The establishment of a military dictatorship in 1926 brought with it a stern censorship of all Fado lyrics, but also saw the expansion of the genre all over the country through the development of the recording industry and the advent of radio. In the 1930s and 40s, a growing network of small restaurants with resident Fado performers led to the birth of a new generation of professional singers who established new performance codes and greatly enlarged the genre's repertoire. Greatest among these was singer and composer Alfredo Marceneiro.
Alfredo Marceneiro, toda a vida para cantar o fado até à morte.
Lisboa, velha cidade, cheia de encanto e beleza.
But Fado also found remarkable exponents in Herminia Silva, a major star of the musical theater, and even in amateur artists born into aristocratic families like Countess Maria Teresa de Noronha. Associated with Fado is a musical instrument unique to Portugal, the 12-string pear-shaped Portuguese guitar. In the 1930s and 40s, guitar virtuosos such as Armandinho revolutionized the instrumental techniques used for accompanying the voice and developed a rich soloistic Fado repertoire. In the late 1940s and 50s, an extraordinary voice emerged from the circles of the Lisbon Fado and conquered the international music hall circuit, Amália Rodrigues.
Se uma gaivota viesse trazer o céu de Lisboa.
She became a household name and a hallmark of Portuguese culture all over the world. A Amália also attracted to Fado some of the greatest poets of the Portuguese language, linking high literature and popular culture in a way that the genre had never known. She opened the way for an even wider international exposure of Fado in the next generation of performers, especially with Carlos do Carmo. In the decades that followed the Democratic Revolution of 1974, a new wave of Fado singers emerged with Camané, Mísia, Cristina Branco, and more recently, Kátia Guerreiro, Ana Moura, and Marisa. They entered the first row of the World Music International circuit and reinforced the role of Fado as worldwide acknowledged symbol of the Portuguese cultural identity. Combining the time-honored Fado traditions with crossover experiments with other musical languages and genres, these young artists also strengthened the role of Fado as an identity factor, cherished and shared by the Portuguese youth.
O Museu do Fado foi criado em 1998, reunindo as coleções de centenas de artistas que não hesitaram em oferecer ao museu os testemunhos do seu património afetivo e memorial em prol de um projeto comum. As coleções do museu integram periódicos, repertórios, instrumentos musicais, cartazes, fotografias, troféus, adereços de atuação, artes plásticas, entre muitos outros testemunhos que fizeram a história do Fado. No quadro desta candidatura, tem vindo a ser desenvolvido, em cooperação com o Instituto de Etnomusicologia, um importante levantamento de fontes documentais, bibliográficas, iconográficas, na posse de outras entidades arquivísticas e museológicas. E temos hoje um conhecimento muito mais sólido da realidade patrimonial física do Fado no território nacional.
O Fado nasceu nos bairros populares de Lisboa, e é uma canção com que a cidade toda hoje se identifica. Nós queremos preservar o Fado como queremos preservar o nosso património cultural construído mais importante, os Jerónimos ao Castelo, como temos orgulho no nosso rio e nessa luminosidade única que é a cidade de Lisboa. Por isso, o município, a Câmara, a Assembleia Municipal, lançaram esta candidatura e aprovaram esta candidatura. Mas hoje sabemos que o Fado já representa mais do que a cidade de Lisboa. Representa, no fundo, todos os portugueses. Em todo o país, mas também em todo o mundo onde se encontra um português. E é por isso que tivemos um apoio tão caloroso de todos, do Governo, do Parlamento e do Presidente da República. Posso dizer que esta é uma candidatura hoje verdadeiramente nacional e representativa de todos os portugueses e que todos os portugueses têm o coração com esta candidatura.
Eu sou um homem na cidade. Amanhã cedo acorda e canta. E por amar a liberdade, como a cidade se levanta.
In almost two centuries of history, Fado has constantly evolved to match the rhythm of change of Portuguese culture as a whole. It remains, however, faithful to its essential nature. A song of Lisbon and of Portugal, a song open to the sea and to the world, eager to be not only a symbol of Portuguese identity, recognized as such internally and abroad, but also a permanent bridge for multicultural dialogue. And as such, it represents indeed a major Portuguese contribution to the world's common intangible cultural heritage.
Eu sou o homem que transporta. A maré povo em sobressalto. E quando agarro a madrugada, colho a manhã como uma flor. À beira mágoa desfolhada, o mal me quer azul na cor. O mal me quer da liberdade, que bem me queres como ninguém. O mal me quer desta cidade, que me quer bem, que me quer bem.